Hello, and thank you for your interest in the Click2Mail add-in for Microsoft Word. The Click2Mail add-in for Office 365 is compatible with Windows Word versions 2013, 2016, and Word for Mac versions 15.18 or later. The add-in makes it possible for you to turn your Microsoft Word documents, like invoices, letters, legal documents, business correspondence, or any other written communication into real postal mail in a matter of minutes. The process is easy. You start with a Microsoft Word document, attach it to a mailing, assign a recipient to the mailing, and then you submit your order. The add-in is free, and you don't have to pay for anything unless you submit a job. For this example, I'm going to mail a sample invoice that I've saved to my desktop. To get started, launch the add-in from your Microsoft Word toolbar. You won't be required to log in or even create an account until you're ready to designate a recipient for your mail, but for the purposes of creating this tutorial, I'm actually going to get started by logging into my Click2Mail account. Accounts are easy to create, and you won't be asked to enter credit card information until you're ready to make a purchase. The login option is available from the hamburger menu in the upper right-hand corner of the add-in. To get started in the order process, I'm going to click Get Started. Next, I'm going to select a product type and click Continue. Then, I'll click Attach Current Document. Now I'm going to tell Click2Mail where to send my mail. There are four ways to do this, and once you designate recipients for your mail, you'll be asked to log into your Click2Mail account if you've not already done so. The first option for adding recipients to a mailing is to capture an address that's already located on the document. To do this, highlight the address and click Capture Address. The address will appear in a mailing label, and you can click Proceed with this address to continue. The second option for adding a recipient to a mailing is to enter it here in the add-in. I'll click Create Single Address to continue, view it on the mailing label, and then click Proceed with this address. The third option for adding a recipient or recipients to a mailing list is to select a list that's already been saved in your account. Click the Saved List tab to view these previously created or imported mailing lists, select one, and click Continue. The final option for adding addresses to a job is to import a new list. Your list needs to have a header row that gives titles to each of the columns. Start by clicking the Import tab and then Import List. Now I'm going to give the list a name, and after naming the list, I'm going to click Choose File to locate it on my desktop, and then I'll click Import Address File. Now I'm going to tell Click2Mail how to print the recipient address label. As I select fields from my mailing list, the mailing label will populate to show how they'll print. Required fields include one name field, address, city, state, and zip. Once I'm done with the recipient address block, I'll click Continue. The add-in will display five mailing labels. You can verify them for accuracy and click Validate this list. Now the add-in is going to tell me if any of my addresses are unmailable or non-standard. Unmailable addresses are incomplete, and you probably want to delete those from your list. Non-standard addresses can't be verified as valid delivery addresses, so you might want to review them carefully and determine if you do in fact want to mail to them. You can download the Excel list from the add-in to delete unmailables and review non-standard addresses by clicking Download List for correction. Open the downloaded file to view unmailable addresses highlighted in pink and delete them. Non-standard addresses will include a description that indicates why they were deemed non-standard by the USPS Delivery Address Database, and you can make any necessary corrections. When you've finished, save the list changes. You'll return to your document to choose the updated file, then click Revalidate. Updated list data will be displayed. Review it and click Import this list. Next, click Continue with mailing. Now it's time to elect print and postage options for the mailing. And what you see displayed here is going to depend on the product type that you selected earlier. For this example, I'm going to change the print color to black and white and then click Continue. On this screen, you'll have the option to download proof. You can also select a mailing date for your order. Click2Mail add-in jobs are paid for with user credit. If you don't already have user credit on your account, you'll have the option to purchase it now. When you're ready to finish, click Submit Job. You'll receive an order submitted message that includes an invoice number, and this will also be emailed to you. You can view your order status and history by clicking Manage Account from the hamburger menu in the upper right-hand corner. That's all for now. You can contact our customer support department at 866-665-2787 or support@click2mail.com if you have any questions about how to use the add-in. Thank you again for your interest in Click2Mail.